In JavaScript, we discussed about types, how to provide JavaScript for HTML.
Yeah.
The one is inline JavaScript. The second one is internal JavaScript, and third one is external JavaScript, and fourth one is browser console. And one more thing is something like online editors. There are multiple things we can able to do practice and all. This JavaScript and all. Okay, one by one we will see. We already finished out how to work out with inline, how to work out with internal, and today we are discussing about external JavaScript. How to provide external JavaScript? External JS related to complete application. Okay, so and external JS. Files are saved as .js format. So .js format is very important, and external JS files integrated for HTML in script tag. For example, if I am going to be preparing a JS file like a file.js, in file.js I am going to be writing some JavaScript code. Okay, some JavaScript code. I am going to be writing some JavaScript code inside the file.js. Okay, what I want to do is inside my HTML, something like index.html, I am going to be preparing index.html over there. Inside the index.html, what we need to do is we need to open script tag, script src. And that src is a file.js. Whatever the JS file we prepared, that JS file we need to integrate inside the script tag. Inside the script tag, we need to integrate that particular JS file. For example, I will tell you how the external JavaScript is going to be preparing. For example, this is your HTML file and this is your JavaScript file. This is your JavaScript file and this is your HTML file. And what we want to do is, we need to integrate these JavaScript file into the HTML part. So whenever you want to integrate these JS code in your HTML, what I want to do is I need to write a script tag here. I need to write a script tag and I need to provide SRC attribute over there. With this SRC, I just want to integrate that particular JS file. Am I clear?
Yeah.
Even though I'll be having multiple JS files, all the files I need to integrate into the HTML in the same format like the script SRC format. So this is very simple. I will tell you how this is going to be work for you. And one more thing is JavaScript is case sensitive. I will tell you what is case sensitive. And JavaScript is simple. And JavaScript is open source. Okay, and JavaScript render in browser. Every browser can able to understand JavaScript. So for any browser, you can work with the JavaScript. HTML and CSS and JavaScript, all these particular three things are major building blocks of each and every web page. Whatever the web page we are going to be preparing, for each and every web page, these are the fundamental things. HTML is for designing part, CSS is for decoration part, and JavaScript is for functional part. See, completely a functionality we need to make implement for that particular website, JavaScript is must. And that particular JavaScript also, we just want to go from this particular inline, internal, external. Inline is element level, internal is page level. Only for that particular page the script will execute. External is global, external for every HTML. Suppose I'll be having a lot of HTML files, for each and every HTML file I will integrate. Suppose I'll be having a lot of HTML files like this. So these are the multiple HTMLs and I have a JS file, simple JS file writing separately. These JS can be included in each and every HTML like this. You got to understand?
Yeah.
This is my HTML and this is my HTML and this is my HTML. I am writing three HTML files here. For each and every file, I can able to integrate this JS file. That is your external JS. Whenever you have external JS is including in your HTML with SRC attribute. That's a very simple thing. I will write one simple example, then you can understand how the things are happening with that. Okay, so let me save this one on top of your folder. Okay, inside your folder, let me take a new folder. Okay, day 11. And this will be external JavaScript. External underscore JS dot HTML. Every file should be HTML file only. Please prepare HTML file first. And file name is external JS. Okay, what my requirement now? So I am loading external JS here. External JS loading here. What I want to do is, I just want to prepare new JS file separately. I'm going to be preparing a new JavaScript file separately. See, whenever you want to prepare JavaScript file, that should be saved as .js format. Okay, my file name is file.js. .js is important. .js is important. Okay, please remember it.
Mm-hmm.
And what that particular .js will be having, alert, simple alert, alert. Okay, JS loading from external. That's it. I'm writing a simple thing. No semicolons are required. In JavaScript, semicolons optional. If you don't put semicolon, okay, file will be executed. But I should integrate this JS file in my HTML. How to integrate JS in HTML is very simple. Okay, so script, inside the script tag, open tag, I need to provide an attribute called SRC. Inside the SRC, I need to integrate a JS file, file.js. My file got integrated. Whatever the file we created, file.js, that file was properly integrated with the external file, HTML file. Now, execute the HTML. HTML will be executed in the browser. And JS loading from external. Yes, it is loading fine. So that whatever the external JavaScript we are writing, that is executing fine. We don't have any issues with that. Sir, I want to write internal JavaScript also. How to write internal JavaScript, sir? How to write internal JavaScript?
Yes,
script open, script talk.
Yeah.
Okay. And here also I'm writing an alert box. Alert. JS loading from internal. JS loading from internal. Fine. So now there are two JavaScript files are there. One is the external JS loading. And one is the internal JS loading. This is the internal JS loading. So this is external JS loading process and this is the internal JS loading process. Okay, line by line. In eighth line or seventh line, we are actually loading external JavaScript. In 12th line, I'm loading the internal JavaScript. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Eighth line, external JS and 12th line, internal JS. Now my output is very simple. When I execute my browser, first JS is loading from external. JS loading from external, that is executing first. Immediately, JS loading from internal. Why? Because line by line execution. So JavaScript.
Can we change the title of this alert box?
Yes. JavaScript loading line by line. Yes. Let me change the alert title. So already some title is coming, right?
Yeah.
What do you want? Title change for?
Just this page says.
The page says, yes. The page says, yeah. That will be same something, that alert title. Okay, so that is alert title. Okay, so if you want title for alert, you can put the confirm boxes, not alert boxes.
Okay.
That is customizing. So I will tell you that one later. That is okay. Like a confirm box. Okay. This is simple alert box. Okay, fine. This is executing line by line. How to know this is loading line by line? For example, I put internal first and I'm putting external second. Now you can easily get understand line by line execution. Eighth line is first, 13th line is second, right? Now what is output first?
Yeah.
First one is internal. Rupesh says internal,
yeah.
That is first. The second one is external. Why? Because loading line by line. For example, in body onload, I am loading something. Body onload also, I am writing some alert box. Loading from, okay, I can't put double quotes again, right? We put single quote and loading from JS loading from. JS loading from inline, yes or not? Okay, now you can see, now you can see inline is always, sorry, internal is always first. Why? Because internal is first level, right? Where is internal? Yes, this is the first line. And after the internal, external. Can you see that? Second one is external.
Yes.
Second one is external. And then third one, is
line by line.
Line by line execution. So JS JavaScript is line by line execution anytime. Whatever the JavaScript you are writing in your page on your HTML, that is line by line execution that you have to get understand. And that is fundamental.
Okay.
That is fundamental. JS executing line by line is fundamental thing. Okay, after that, we need to get understand. Okay, sir, I want to write some document accessing process, DOM accessing process. Okay, let me take a DOM here. Okay, let me take a DOM. So from DOM, I want to access the H1. So hello, JavaScript. Hello, JavaScript. This is my H1. Okay, I want to access the H1 and I need to do something in the part of the internal here. This is internal, right? Okay, how to access that? Document dot get elements by tag name. Your tag name is h1 dot inner html. I want to change inner html. So Noor. Okay, I know. Okay, something I'm saying that. I know. Okay, fine. Now, this JavaScript is overriding your hello JavaScript, right? Hello JavaScript is overriding with the hi Noor, right? Can you see that? Okay, first, internal executed. External executed, inline executed, and you can see something. Hello JavaScript. What happened with hello JavaScript? So external JS is loading. Hello JavaScript is loading fine. But what the problem? The problem is JavaScript on the top. JavaScript on the top, but your document on the bottom. The document can't understand, right? Your document can't understand. So what you need to do?
Yeah.
After the H1 only, you need to load some script. See, whatever the scripts you are writing, please put bottom of the screen, bottom of the body. So whenever your body is closing, you please load all the JavaScripts. After writing your documents, after writing your HTML, please mention your JavaScript code. So here you need to mention your JavaScript code. That is a better one for manipulation purpose. That is a better one for manipulation purpose. This is the JavaScript code, fine. So where I want to put my JavaScript code? JavaScript code is on the body, in the body, end of the body. End of the body, nothing but before closing the body, I need to place all my JavaScript code. That is a better way. That is a better way to change your inner HTML. Okay, let me execute now the same application. Yes, internal is loading, external is loading, inline is loading. Now you can see hello JavaScript. Hello JavaScript still available. What's the problem? Can you see that? What is the issue there?
The comments.
Yeah, something is missing. Hello JavaScript is there. Okay, the tag name is document.getElementsBy. Yes, H1 should have index.
Yeah.
H1 should have index. Why? Because we have only one HTML. Even one H1 also there. Even one H1 also there, we need to mention the index. Without index, it cannot recognize. Without array index, it cannot recognize from the DOM. So DOM is manipulating with array. So definitely you should mention index. So whenever you close this, already came. I know. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now yeah. What I want to do is I want to write a same line from the document.getElementById and go to the file.js. And here, hi CNAS. Okay. My content will update with you. How your content will update. Internal is loading, external is loading, inline is loading, hi Srinivas already came. Hi Srinivas came. Why hi Srinivas came? Actually, here the by default the text of H1 is hello JavaScript. Hello JavaScript got updated with Inode. Inode got updated with Hi Srinivas. Finally, the visualization is Hi Srinivas. Finally, on top of the browser is on Hi Srinivas, right? Am I correct?
Yes.
Finally, so
external
JavaScript
external JS also executing at the last.
Yes, yes. External JavaScript executing at the last. External JavaScript okay. executing at the last. For example,
if we move this one.
Yes, okay, down. Yeah, if I move this down, if I move this down, yeah. okay, obviously the title will be high mode.
Yeah. That's it.
This is the way of understanding your loading of JavaScript, how your JavaScript yeah, okay, is loading good. In your page, even though you're writing a lot of JavaScript files. Okay, for example, your formula will be in the 10th JavaScript. Okay, but you're writing 5th JavaScript at the last. Fifth line of Java, fifth file in the last, but your formula will be in the 10th JavaScript. The 10th JavaScript you are putting on the top side. Obviously, your mm-hmm. output will not come. There is no errors. Nothing will be executing for you. But the thing is, whenever you are writing the JavaScript, we have to put a completely sense where I am writing my file. That file is end of the execution or not. Whatever the formula you want to execute, that formula should be end of the JavaScript. Okay, end the JavaScript, then only it will execute. Otherwise, it will not get executed for you. So that's a way of remembering external JavaScript, how to write external JavaScript and how to work with external JavaScript and all. Now, the last thing is, fourth one is console, browser console, how to work with the browser console. Every browser having some console window, browser console window. Let me show. So this is my Chrome. Let me take a new program, browser console process. Let me take a new program. Okay, JS from console. .html. I want to show some JavaScript in the browser console. Okay, so I'm saving here. And I want to show some JavaScript. Check JavaScript. Check JavaScript in browser console. Check JavaScript in browser console. I want to open console window, then only you can able to check your JavaScript. Open the browser. So check JavaScript in browser console here. How to open console window for the Chrome? Chrome browser having console window with inspect. Right click inspect and check the browser console here, console window here. And there you can write your JavaScript code. Okay, for example, I want to write some JavaScript code like alert, but I want to do something like alert, okay. So whenever you say that, can you see this? JS is yeah. working. Okay, I want to do some practices like, after that alert, I want to define some variable name, where name equal to something like Noor. Okay, what is the name now? What is the name now? Okay, name, yeah. I want to update with the Srinivas. Okay, what is the name now? Console.log. Mm-hmm. Console.log. Console.log is like a printf in your C language.
Yeah.
Okay, so name is, comma, name. What is the name? Now, what is the name? Name is Srinivas. Can you see that?
Yeah.
So, age equal to 32. Okay, so I want to print console.log age is 32. Now I want to show something like a console.log age. Can you see that age is 32? Can you see that? Okay,
yeah.
Where okay, x equal to 10, x, y equal to 20, x plus xy, what is output now? 30, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the way you can write your JavaScript code. For example, I want to write something document.write. I'm accessing document first, document.write. On top of the document, I want to paste something. I want to paste something.
It's just for practice, right?
Yeah, this for only for practice. I will tell you why this console is. Why? Because whenever you have some error, this console will give you the proper output here. Okay, I will show. Okay.
Okay.
For example, I want to show some H1. Okay, document.write. I want to place one H1. Hello door. H1 close. Okay, can you see that?
Yeah.
Hello need place right. When I say document.write, hello Srinivas. Can you see that? Hello Srinivas also placed.
No.
Hello JavaScript. What happened? Hello JavaScript place.
Yeah.
Okay, so can I take a list item there? OL. LI. Apple. Mango, orange. Okay, can you see the output of this? Can you see that? Order is created. See, from JavaScript also you can able to create HTML. From JavaScript also you can create HTML. That is a line called a document.write. I will tell you this line data. But you can understand how the console is going to be working for you. And let me tell you one thing. For example, in the JS console, what I want to do is I am writing some internal JavaScript. Okay, x equal to 10. Console.log. Okay, console.log or something like alert x. But I want to show alert, right? I want to show alert. But what is the browser? What is the output of this? 10. What is the output of the browser? Then some inspection you can go for, and you can go for console. Yes, fine, it is working. So we don't have any issue with the script. Right? So x equal to 10. Inside the script, x equal to 10 we are placing, and alert something like that. Okay, I want to do something like console.log x. Now execute the same browser. Same browser output. Okay, 10 came, but some console error came. Can you see console now?
Yeah.
What is the console error? Can you see the console error? You can go for the line. When you press on the error, 9th line you have the issue.
Yeah.
9th line you have the JavaScript issue. What is the JavaScript issue here? Console spelling mistake. Yeah. Okay, so instead of doing this, I need to go for the console.log. L-O-G, console.log. Okay, so I'm putting X. Is it fine now?
Yeah.
Is it fine now? Spelling is correct for console?
Yeah.
Still you have issue. Still you have issue. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, so check the issue. 10th lines. Still we have the issue. What is the issue? The issue is we don't put capital letter for console. I told you JavaScript is case sensitive. Very, very careful.
Okay.
Now this is small letter. Okay, for example, I put a capital letter for L. I'll put a capital letter for L. Still having the issue. Can you see that?
Yeah.
So this is the issue. So you can't able to describe the issue. What is the issue here? Uncaught type errors. Console.log is not a function. Whatever the function you are writing, that is error. It is not a function. That is not a JavaScript function. But what is the right JavaScript? Console.log is the right JavaScript. This is the right JavaScript. This is the way you have to understand writing JavaScript procedures. Okay, now there is no console outputs. There is no console issue, and output came properly. Value 10. Value 10. Got understand?
Yeah.
Okay. So for example, I am writing console.log. Okay. X value is X. Okay. Now you can check it out. Console issue came. Uncaught syntax missing something arguments. What is the argument missing in the line called 14th line? In 14th line, we have the issue. We write the console.log properly, but somewhere we are making mistake. That mistake you can't able to see. Okay, what the mistake properly? Uncaught syntax error, missing parenthesis after argument list. Missing parenthesis after argument list. But this is, you can't understand what is the error properly exactly. So that's why we need to understand the syntax properly. After double quotes, we need to give a comma. After double quotes, we need to provide comma, and I will provide X, capital X. Where is capital X? Will be having anywhere capital X? Console error, uncaught type reference error, X is not defined. What it is saying that?
X is not defined. Yet.
Sir, you are actually providing some X, but X is not defined. You are not defining X anywhere. What do you want to do? You need to provide a small X. That's called case sensitive. I am telling already, JavaScript is case sensitive. Very, very careful. This is not like HTML and CSS. JavaScript is case sensitive. Each and every character we should understand. Each and every syntax we should understand. So that is the reason whenever you are practicing the JavaScript, very, very careful, you need to make it work with them. Okay. And this is the console outputs. Checking the console outputs are very, very simple. Okay. For browser called Chrome, console is different. For browser called Firefox, console is different. Let me open Firefox browser. Okay. Let me open the Firefox browser. The same output I want to check. But Firefox console is different. Okay, let me check the same output in the Firefox. This is a 10 output came, but Firefox console in different way. How to go with the Firefox console? Firefox tools, web developer, web console. Can you see?
Yeah.
Tools, web developer, web console. This is the console of the Firefox. What is the console output of the Firefox now? X, 10, X value is 10. Okay, some HTML characters are not going to be properly done. So the character encoding with HTML is having issue. That is one simple thing we have to do. It's not an issue. It's not an error. It is simple issue. Okay, so that's a very simple thing. You need to provide some meta and something. So this is the issue actually came with the Firefox. Firefox is very, very sensitive. It is giving you the proper issues and all. Now the issue gone. Can you see that issue also gone?
Yeah.
We need to mention some meta characters at UTF-8, something like that. That is also we need to understand in the part of HTML, but that is not error, that is simple issue. That is not error, that is a simple issue. But understand how the browser console will be?
Yeah.
And one more thing is online editors. There are multiple online editors which are going to be available for JavaScript practice. Let me go for jsbin.com. Okay, for browser console, for Chrome, how to do? Right click.
Chrome tools.
Right click.
Web developer. Okay. Inspect.
Inspect.
Yeah, web.
Click on console. Console.
Yeah.
Inspect. And click on console. Write down JavaScript. Write down JS. That's it. Okay, for Chrome, sorry, for Firefox. How to do Firefox? Okay, Firefox is different. Tools, web developer, web console. Tools, web developer, web console. Tools, web developer, web console. Am I clear? Tools, web developer, web console. That is for Firefox. In Safari, you have different way. Each and every browser having its own console processor. Okay, for Safari also I will show. If you are working with Safari, if you are working with a MacBook, that is a different concept. Copy appearance Safari. Yeah, open it. Then this alert is different, right? Safari, this is Safari. And for Safari, the browser console go somewhere. Window, browser console, maybe Safari right click. Here it is now. Browser console, where is the browser console? Okay, let me check Safari. I don't use Safari. Okay, go to Safari preferences. Okay. Safari preferences. After preferences, advanced tab, you will find out the developer console.
Yeah, I see a show development in a menu bar.
Yes.
Yeah, it's already there.
Option command C.
Yes, already over there. Bookmark develop.
Okay. Go to console. Web console window. This is responsive mode.
Show JavaScript console.
That's fine. Here you can see the output 10 and x value is 10. Everything clear. Okay. Yeah. That's a way of Safari. So just go with Safari and all. Okay, for Safari, this is the thing you need to do. So let's go with this. I'm copying this one. But most people are not using it Safari. Okay. And there are a lot of online editors also there. Just go with online editors like jsbin.com. You can go for jsbin.com like this. Whenever you go for jsbin.com, you can go with our direct practice like JavaScript here. Okay, something like alert. Okay, so alert, okay, if you want to show something, very, very sensitive this one. What is output for alert now? Something that.
Okay,
I want to show something like console.log. You can able to show console.log also. And document.write, something like hello. JavaScript. Can you see that output came?
Yeah.
Okay, so document.write. I want to show H1 tag. H1 open, H1 close. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is a way of writing your browser. Sorry, online editor. JavaScript practicing with online editor. You can write HTML, CSS also. For example, for CSS, I want to write color. Can you see that?
Yeah.
You can do very, very easily. You can do practice HTML, CSS, JavaScript side by side. And you can see the console outputs also there. Console.log. Okay, can you see the console output here?
Yeah.
Console.log. Okay, so console.log. Something like a node. Okay, node came. Can you see here? See, everything you can see. HTML you can see, CSS you can see, JavaScript you can see, console you can see, output you can see. Everything will be available in the single window. That is like a JS window. From tomorrow onwards, we will do work on this one, online editor. The complete programming syntaxes, I will explain with you online editor. Okay. And there are a lot of online editors which are going to be available. If you want, you can just check it out. JS online editors. There are a lot of editors which are JS Fiddle is one thing. You can do JavaScript practices with the JS Fiddle.net. And you can do a lot of practices over there. And you can write HTML here, you can write CSS here, you can write JavaScript here. Console.log. Console.log. Hi. So when I say hi, and this will be having some console output. Okay, so console will be somewhere. Can I say something like alert? So this is my JavaScript. Okay, run. Hi came. Can you see that hi came?
Yeah.
So this is a way, one way to go with the JS Fiddle.net and JavaScript online editor with the WP schools. And one more thing, like playcode.io. You can go with the playcode.io also, open editor. Just open the editor and you want to practice with the JavaScript. Whatever the JavaScript you want, you can do that. So console.log, something like that. Some JavaScript is there, right? Anything you can do practice over there. So style is there, index is there, HTML is there, CSS is there, JavaScript is there. Everything you can do practice. Everything fine?
Yeah.